Hello guys, first of all welcome everyone in Talented Developer. Today we are going to learn about LDAP. So what is LDAP? We'll also learn what is difference between LDAP and Active Directory. We'll also try to see how LDAP works and what is the structure of LDAP. So let's begin this tutorial. What is AD? AD stands for Active Directory. It will use to provide the authentication, group and user management. It is also used to create the policy. It will authenticate and authorize all kind of user and their computers. So LDAP stands for Lightweight Directory Access Protocol. As name suggests, it is lightweight client server protocol. It is used to access and manage the directory information. So in other way we can say like that, it is an open and cross platform used for directory services authentication. LDAP is a directory service protocol that runs over TCP/IP protocol. So, what is difference between LDAP and Active Directory? LDAP is a way of speaking to the Active Directory. Here, Active Directory is a directory services database and LDAP is one of the protocol that is used to talk to it. How LDAP works? Suppose you are using a web application. In that, you have entered your username and password. Then it will go to the API and services. After that, it will call the LDAP and Active Directory. Suppose your username or password is wrong. On that time, you are not going to access this one. So you will get an error message. After that, again, you have to enter. Suppose in case of correct username and password, you have entered, then that means like you are authorized person, you have authenticated. Then it will again come back to the services and after that it will show message like okay, you are authorized person, go and use this application. Why we need to use LDAP? Suppose you are working in an organization of 10,000 of employees and you need to create security policy for every single person or different kind of person. So what is here security policy? Here security policy means like suppose some user can access this file. Some user can download only this kind of file. So how you can do? You cannot sit on every single computer and create a single policy for every person. That is not going to work even also. It will take so much time, maybe like forever also. So what you can do? You can create security policy within the domain controller. So what is the benefit of that one? In that security policy, you can define who has access to use that file, who has access to see that folder and who has access to download some kind of file or who have access to change their desktop background. So that's why we are going to use LDAP. So let's move to the other section. So what is the structure of LDAP? So it is a tree kind of a structure. Don't imagine like it is a real tree. So here tree referred means like it is a starting from the root. So you have a root. After that, you will have next one, means like DC. Here DC equal to example and DC equal to com. So what is here DC? DC refer means domain component. So DC object represents the top of LDAP tree that use DNS to define the namespace. Next one, here we'll have our OU and group. So what is here OU? OU stand for organization unit. OU object act as a container that holds all kind of object. They provide a structure to the LDAP. Here you can see I'm having a group. So what is group? I will explain after some time. After that in OU, we can gather all kind of user. Here you can see CN. CN refer common name. So common name is a John. So let's move to the real kind of example. Suppose you are having an organization. That organization name is a ABC and it have some different branches like developer, business, finance, different kind of departments. After that in developer you are having one more department like backend. And in business you are having some persons. In finance also you are having some department like here accounts. So in backend group you can see like in backend department you are having a person. Her person name is John. He belongs to India. So same thing, if we are going to compare with this structure, how we can see. So let's see. Here it is starting from the root. Okay, after that you can see DC. So here we can say like this is organization. So here O means like it is organization. Next section, here you can see, here we are having organization unit, like here developer, business, finance. After that again we are having one more department, like backend. So we can say like it is organization unit. So here you can see it is kind of hierarchy, like organization, again it having organization unit, or it can have directly the attributes, like here you can see John, but here we are having two organization unit. So what is here organization unit and what is group? So suppose you are working in organization and you want to share a account files. Okay, so you cannot want to share that file to everyone. So definitely you need to create some kind of group. So what you can do, here you can see, here you can create a group. In that group you can just add the account department here. So what will happen, all the person that belongs to account, that will be in account department. Okay, so like account group. So account group, you have to add the security policy, like only account person can access that kind of file. Similarly for backend also you can do same kind of structure. You have to create a group, and in that group you have to add your security policy. So in that group you can add your organization unit. So what will happen, only the certain file or certain person can access this kind of file. So here organization unit is also used for admin level, means like suppose your 100 developers are working, okay, and they need some kind of file access. So they will not come to the security person and they can say like, okay, network admin, please give that permission to me. So what they can do, they can create a group. Okay, in that group they can create a super admin. Super admin, like only for, I'm talking about developer group, I'm not talking about full organization. So what will happen, in developer also they will have one hierarchy, like one will be admin. So they can give all the access regarding the developer group to that person. So what will happen, all the person that belongs to developer group, they can go and ask the security policy for that person. They're not going to disturb the main network admin. So similarly for different group, they can give permission to a single person. So what will happen, he can control all the people in that group. So that's, it will work. So here attribute is a John. Suppose you want to call the person John, so how we can call? So always we have to start from the down level. So here CN means John Mark. Okay, he belongs to organization unit, that name is organization unit. Okay, see here is the backend. So we'll give here CN John Mark, OU equal to backend, again OU, and he belongs to developer. So we give him developer, and that developer will come from organization. So here O equal to ABC. So you can see how it's work. So suppose here organization name is a company, we can say like O means organization is company. He having two things, organization unit as a user, in that user all kind of user will be there, and in other side they are having one groups, in that group they are having one admin group. So one person can belong to different group also. So in user, suppose 100 person are there, okay, that one first person is a Ram, that Ram can be admin of that group. So how we can call the Ram from this one? So it is very simple. Here we have to use group of unique names. So what will happen, if we are going to call Ram from here, so we can easily call like CN equal to Ram and it belongs to OU equal to users and company O. But in case of group of unique name, we can say like unique member equal to, it's like unique member, so he is the unique member of some group. Then we have to call same thing here, unique member equal to CN Ram and OU equal to users and he belongs to company. So this is a way to call them. Next one, we have to remember some terms like here O means organization name, OU means organization unit, CN means common name. Similarly, they are having some kind of naming structure. We have to definitely follow. Next, you can see they have divided into objects. So, what is authentication and what is the type of authentication? Mainly, it is two types. First one is simple. So, in simple, what will happen? You have to enter the username and password. Then it will go and bind. Then it will check like it is a valid user or that user having authentication or not. Suppose if it is authorized person, then he can easily access. Next one is SSL. So in that, what will happen? SSL binds is more involved and allow the client and server to negotiate a particular authentication mechanism which they use to authenticate the LDAP connection. They can create their security policies, then they can easily configure everything. So thank you guys for watching this one. Please like the video and subscribe my channel, and please share it with your friends. Thank you guys.